The world is already embracing Docker at a rapid pace because it is so applicable to a wide range of audiences. For us, we wanted to tie the explosive growth of Docker together with a couple of other important foundational technologies, platforms as a service and microservices. We think if you are using those three technologies together, you will end up with something that is greater than the sum of the parts.
Services are like a process, and now with the advent of containerization technology, the container is very much that process. It encapsulates more and more of the dependencies of the running service so that we can have quite independent services that run containers that run alongside each other, connected together through these standard interfaces.
People who adopt this style of system creation will have systems that are more flexible, easier to change, more robust, and that will support team structures that we think are more conducive to building good software.
Using this higher level abstraction programming model, where you can think about containerization as a level of encapsulation and isolation, cuts down on coordination costs across silos, and it frees up developers to be a lot more agile in the things they do and the way they can attack things like localized testing and QA and even more aggressive engineering practices like continuous delivery and continuous deployment.
We've seen a lot of organizations take platform as a service or simply a virtualization platform and call that private cloud. And we have a blip on the radar, in fact, that we think people should avoid.
Platform as a service often doesn't live up to the potential that really could be there, and it's a significant barrier.
Some of those things that you need to have in order to really call something a cloud would be self-service pooled resources. You want developers and you want development teams to be able to provision, spin up, shut down resources on demand very quickly and easily over a generally available network. Microservices are another form of SOA, but I view this as a chance for us to get it right this time.
We're seeing more and more of this level of operational encapsulation happening, and we think it's a good thing because it frees up developers to not worry so much about things that formerly were not under their control.
But there's no product, there is no platform, there is no tool that takes the place of having the right capabilities, of hiring the right people. Like every revolution in IT, this trend towards platform as a service and microservices, etc., has led to a gold rush of tool and platform vendors trying to address this market. And it's given businesses a tendency to think that they can somehow buy their way into this capability.